The story is this. It was like my first time as a teaching assistant, and I was a teaching assistant for senior problem solving. And so we select, me and the professor, we select some problems for the student. And we took some of these problems from the monthly, that is this journal in which in every number there is like, I don't know, a couple of problems that are easy to state, and they should be easy to solve in the sense, not easy, but like solvable with elementary things, okay? So this was one of these problems that I select, and I was thinking about it, and I wasn't able to solve it, okay? I'm going to say it, and I have the solution, okay? Because usually after a couple of years, the solution like are like published by people. Yes. If you have the solution, you can like write them and they will publish it probably. Okay. I don't know if like always the solution are like a couple of years after the publication of the problems. I don't know if it's like just a matter of time or it's just because people need time to solve it. Okay. Are not easy problem. Okay. Someone like is not completely difficult. It's not really difficult, but someone can be tricky. Okay. This one is one of I was thinking was tricky. Okay. So. And this, like, let me say the problem, okay? So I'm going to write it here, so we have it. So suppose f is a function from R to R such that the sum as n from 0 to infinity of f of a n converges whenever the sum of a n is convergent. Is a convergent series, maybe. It's a convergent series of real terms, okay? We're talking about real. We have to prove that f is differentiable at the origin. Yeah. Yeah. So the statement is, okay, every time that the series of this a n is a convergent series, these things converge. We have to prove that the function is differentiable at the origin. So. Yes. You can say exactly what is f, actually. I mean, which kind of f it is. But. Okay, because actually what I'm going to prove is the solution of this is prove that f of x is equal to ax, is a linear function. Okay? I mean, it's easy to see that if f is ax, no? Then like, okay? And okay, first of all, like if is continuous and everything, you can see that f of 0 has to be equal to 0. Okay? Because if this has to be infinitesimal, no? Has to go to 0 a n. If f is continuous, then f of 0 has to be 0, because this has to be infinitesimal, so f of 0 has to be 0. Okay?
So side x doesn't work?
No. You can find like some convergent series for which the sign is not sign of this is not convergent.
Well, in that case, I guess it'd be convergent.
Yeah. I think you can find it, yeah. For example, I was thinking why 1 over x squared doesn't work. 1 over x squared doesn't work, the series, the function 1 over x squared. It doesn't, sorry.
X squared.
X squared doesn't work because you can take as an this stuff. Is convergent. But when you take the square, what you get is the harmonic series. So.
Oh, so A n doesn't have to be absolutely
converted. No, just convert it. X cube, you can find something. You take 1 over. You can take, okay, let me think. When you take X cube, if you take something like this, it works, no? Yeah. Hmm? Okay. No? Yes, this is convergent, but when you take the cube, what you get is, this is still convergent. Okay, maybe you take 3 over, you take n to the 3 over 2 or something, no? And it's fine after, no?
If you okay.
But it's like this, okay? You can find stuff, yeah. Okay? So, okay, this is easy to see, no? If it's continuous, this is easy to see. It's easy to see even that fs could be continuous at 0, okay? Because it works like this. Take an, a sequence, going to 0, okay? Now, suppose f of an doesn't go to 0. Okay? So take a sequence, suppose this doesn't go to 0. So this implies there exists a subsequence, ank, such that f of nak. No, suppose this. Suppose this doesn't go to 0.
So
no?
You're showing it's continuous at 0 or that f of 0 is 0?
No, continuous at 0. Okay. So suppose this goes to 0. Suppose that this doesn't go to 0.
Then you have a sequence of sequences?
This is a sequence. This is like f of an is another sequence. Suppose this doesn't go to 0. Okay. So what you get is there exists a subsequence that this is bigger than epsilon. Okay. Now, since this is going to 0, this in particular is going to 0, so you can find a subsequence such that subsequence that this converges. Okay? But these things cannot be convergent. J. These things cannot be convergent. Because everyone is bigger than epsilon. Okay.
So
f has to be continuous at 0.
That just shows when an converges after the converges.
Huh?
It shows that it's limited. It doesn't show that it's continuous. F of 0 could be limited. F of 0 has to be 0 because you take the series 0.
F to 0 has to be 0.
But this doesn't show it's continuous at 0. This just shows that f of an must go to 0.
F of an has to go to 0.
For all
an goes to 0.
Yeah.
That is, converge, continuity at 0. Okay. This could, no, this continuity at 0.
Hold on. If you take an to be 1 over n.
Yeah. I'm just like starting with a sequence.
But hold on, the harmonic series has a convergent subseries or something?
Sure. Yeah. You can always take, if you have a sequence that is going to 0, then you can always find, in this case, ank is going to 0 in particular, no? So you can always find a subsequence that the series converges. Yes, this is true.
So for every sequence, the number is going to 0.
A subsequence. the series, yes, it's converging. It's converging. Okay. So this is what I was actually able to think, stop. and after I took the solution, okay? There was it. And this is cute stuff. So let me say how to prove this, okay? What actually they're going to prove is this, that f of x is equal to kx for some k. In R, okay? So f is linear. How? They are proving this in this way. There are two things to prove. First of all, that there exists a neighborhood of zero. There exists epsilon 1 bigger than zero, such that f of x plus z is equal to f of x plus f of z's. Whenever x and z are in R, the modulus of x and z is less than this epsilon 1. The second thing to prove is there exists epsilon 2 bigger than 0 and a constant k. Okay, such that f of x is less or equal to kx for all x in R, x less than this epsilon 2. Okay, the proof is more general because they say, it's true that they can prove these things whenever the function doesn't have to be from R to R, but from some normed space to some other normed space, okay? So, okay? What I'm saying here is valid only from R to R, okay? But this proof is valid anyhow, okay? From where I mean normed space to normed space, okay? They prove basically that these things have to be a linear things. Okay, so this. So, why these things is enough, it's clear that is enough, okay? But, okay, you can see, no? That now if you take f of x minus f of z, this is equal by the first assertion of f of x minus z, and using the other one, what I get is this, okay? So it's continuous. If I take epsilon to be the mean, if you want, or one half of the mean, okay? Between epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, so now for sure this is less than epsilon. This one, yeah. Using this. How did you use it? Here, f of x minus f of z. Yes, if you want, yes. Okay. Do it like this. Okay. So what you get is that f is continuous. On this ball. Okay? Now these things, the first one actually, only the first one implied the linearity. Okay? Why? Because you have these, okay? So, I want to show first of all that f, if I show that f is linear, I've done, okay? So why the first one is telling me about the linearity? Because of this, okay? because, okay, I have space here, so. It worked like this. What happened here? Minus is fine, no?
Yeah, you replace E with X minus
D. Yeah. Ah, okay, yeah, exactly. So here, what I was saying is that enough to prove that F is linear. How I can prove that F is linear? I want to prove this, that F of lambda X is equal lambda F of X. Okay? So first of all, you prove for lambda rational, okay? So lambda equal P over Q, okay? P in V and Q in N, okay? What you can do is this, you take Q F of P over Q X, okay? Now this is equal to F of, this is a natural number, okay? So now I can apply these things. What I get is P of X. Now P of X, P is in V, so now I know that this is equal actually to P F of X. This implies F of P over Q of X is equal P over Q F of X. Now I know that this is true for rational number. I know that F is continuous. And so it's true for real number in general. For I can use it for irrational number. Okay? So okay, we have to prove one and two. Okay? For which f of x, yes, is equal to kx. Yes, it's a neighborhood of zero, yes.
But if you want to apply one, you need
what?
The p over qx to be...
Yes, has to be everything inside this, okay? Has to be everything inside, yes. Everything I'm saying is a neighborhood of zero. Everything like, you can take... Think about P of X, P over QX, everything is small enough, okay? Such that X, P of X, P over Q, okay, P over QX, everything is inside this neighborhood, okay?
But then how do you do it for large rational?
You don't know for large rational, because you want to prove only that is in a neighborhood. What you want to prove is differentiable at the origin. So you need only a neighborhood of the origin. No, just in a neighborhood.
Then you're for small.
I think you can't say anything in general.
No.
It should be pretty small. Yeah.
What?
You can just stick my root to that single one.
Yeah, as long as X is
here. Yeah.
So.
Yeah, but like you can't put
lambda equal to? No, everything has to be in this neighborhood, okay? Everything has to be in this neighborhood. But you know, like, you have to prove that it's differentiable at the origin, so...
No, I'm being pedantic only because you said the function will be linear, so it should...
No, in a neighborhood of zero, in a neighborhood of zero. It's a neighborhood, in a neighborhood of zero. In a neighborhood of zero. Okay, proof of one. Okay, so, first of all, we prove that F has to be odd. In some neighborhood of zero, okay? Okay. Why? Suppose it is false, no? Indeed. If these were false, we can choose a sequence, okay? Is an odd function in some neighborhood of zero, okay? If it were, choose. A sequence xn converging to zero so that yn equal f of xn minus f of minus plus is different from zero. Okay? Suppose doesn't exist a neighborhood of zero in which the function is odd, okay? Then this means that you can find a sequence converging to zero such that the difference between f of xn and f of minus, I mean the difference, the sum between f of xn plus f of minus xn is different from zero. Okay? Now, choose this number, let me call n, capital N of n, natural number, such that this times yn is bigger than 1. Okay? And now we are going to define a sequence by blocks. Define the sequence aj by blocks. Okay? The nth block will have 2 times n terms obtained by repeating the 2 element xn and minus xn n over n times. Okay? So now you have this, okay? You define this new sequence in blocks, okay? The nth blocks will have this number of terms, and it's done by repeating xn minus xn, xn minus xn, n times, these n times. Okay? So what's happened? Remember, xn is a sequence converging to zero now. So I have that the sequence, okay, I'm going to erase what? This is the statement. I can erase the statement, okay? You see here what I have? I have a contradiction because the series of the xn is convergent. No? This is convergent because xn is going to zero and this in particular is going, no, it's going to zero, this series actually. Okay? It's a series converging to zero. Okay? Because you have xn minus xn, xn minus xn. Okay? Oh, sorry. Yeah, you're right, you're right. Sorry. AJ. Sorry, AJ. The sum in J. Okay? It's convergent, actually, it's convergent to zero. Okay? But this thing is not convergent. Doesn't converge. Why? Because it's not Cauchy. Okay? This thing is not Cauchy. You see? On the nth block, the sum of this stuff is always n to the n yn. I mean, is equal to these things. And this does not converge to zero. This thing, in particular, is bigger than one. Now I'm looking at the tail of the series, okay?
No absolute
Eh?
No absolute volume here.
Year? You need the absolute value for these.
You start with
this year, you need the absolute value. I know, no, I'm thinking, yeah.
I mean, if it's negative, you can just flip, right? Like, take yn.
Yeah, take xn to be the other one, no? You flip the other one. Yeah, exactly. And so you can always think this to be positive, actually, yeah.
So you want to define
so this can be always positive, okay? Different from zero is positive. Otherwise, you flip these two stuff, okay? So what you have is always that this is actually like this. And so there is fine. It's not Cauchy, because every n that you take, you can always find indices that are bigger of this fixed n, such that, no, the difference between these two stuff is...
And you just group them.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, yeah. The tail, no? It's not going to zero. Okay? And so this shows that actually the function has to be odd. Okay. Now, we have to prove one, eh? We still have to prove one. So assume one is false. Okay? So, here is saying, no, that this is true in a neighborhood of zero. So suppose it's false, it means that for every neighborhood of zero, okay, you can find point in which this is not true. The quality is not true. So this means that I can find two sequences, xn, vn, converging to zero. Such that, now let me call yn, be f of xn plus the n minus okay.
This is not zero.
Eh?
It's not zero.
This is not zero, no? Because you are assuming that these are pointing which this is not zero. Okay? So now what you do the same trick as before. But now you are constructing in block of three things, okay? You're taking xn, vn, minus xn, minus vn. Okay, we know the function is odd, okay? So same trick as before, okay? You have aj in block, okay? The nth block as 3 n to the n terms, where n to the n is always like this difference, okay, as 3 n terms, oh, anyhow, this, you don't care if it's positive or negative, okay? Because it's not about flipping the two point. It's because these are some of the same terms. So it's always positive or it's always negative. It's not that you have cancellation between these terms, okay? You see what I'm saying? This yn here, okay, is always, okay, if you take this, it's negative, okay, or it's positive, okay? Let's say that it's negative, okay? What you have in the block here, when you calculate these things on this stuff, you have something that is bigger than 1 is modulus, okay, but this is fine. For sure it's bigger than 1 in modulus, because it's always a positive, it's always negative, okay? You don't care about like beyond always positive, because there cannot be cancellation between these terms, because it's always the same sign, okay? Because here after this trick doesn't work to change the things, eh? You see what I'm saying? So, nth block has 3 times n to the n terms, and is obtained by repeating the 3 terms. X plus the n, xn plus the n, minus xn minus the n. Okay? As before, can I use this? Yes? As before, what we get is that the sum of aj converges, in particular it converges to 0. Okay? But by construction, this sum does not converge. Okay? Because as usual, for any n that you take, at a certain point you have a certain block here of this sequence of f of aj, for which this sum is bigger than 1. Okay? Or smaller than minus 1, but you don't care, this thing is like, you know. It doesn't go to 0. The tail doesn't go to 0. Okay? Okay. And so in particular we proved 1, okay, that f of x plus z is equal to f of x plus f of z in some neighborhood of the origin. Okay? Now I'm going to prove 2. Is it clear so far? Yes? As before, we assume that 2 is false. So we can find a sequence xn such that the modulo of xn is less than 2 to the minus n, while f of xn is bigger than this. Okay? Now note that, as we said before, f of 0 has to be equal to 0. Okay? So this implies that xn, the xn are different from 0 for every n. I showed that it's continuous at 0 before.
Zero. So at the point 0.
At the point 0.
So if you take any positive number, for example, we don't know it's continuous yet.
No, we don't know. Why?
So
we have to prove this, no? And after from this, it's going to follow everything, no? But you know, no? These things that I did before, no? It was proving that f of 0 has to be 0 and f is continuous at 0, no?
That doesn't say anything about any positive number. It doesn't say that, for example, that 1 over a billion is continuous. so I don't know if you could say,
what?
Say how it behaves there.
No, I can't say it. So I'm not saying anything, no? What I'm simply saying is that, okay, suppose this is not true. Suppose this is not true.
No, don't worry, I'm just thinking out loud.
Okay. No?
I'll ask you about the because like something like maybe it's not even bounded variation, right?
Like, that is continuous at zero, it's okay.
Yeah, no, I'm just thinking
but,
I'll ask after.
Okay. This you know, f of zero has to be equal to zero. Now, this implies that x of n is different from zero for every n, okay? Okay, this implies this, okay, because this is bigger than this, okay? So, no one of the xn can be zero, okay? So now again, define a sequence, aj, by block. Okay. So here the nth block has 2 times n terms. Where this number is chosen so that 2 to the minus n minus 1 is less or equal than this times this less or equal to 2 to the minus n. Okay, now these xn are not zero. Okay? No one of these xn is different, every xn is different from zero. So now for every xn you can find capital N of n, such that this is true. Okay? Remember that. This is less than this. Okay? Yes. Okay. And this sequence of AJs consists of n to the n copies of xn followed by n of n copies of minus xn. Okay? Now you see this. For this, I can say that this is convergent. Actually, converges to zero. Okay? Because anyhow, I have that this is always less or equal than 2 to the minus n, the sum of this stuff. Okay? But what I have is. Okay, let me finish here. It's finished. But again, this sum is not Cauchy. Why? Because what is the sum on the nth block? The sum on the nth block, okay? The first nth term, okay? What you have is f of xn n to the n can be positive or negative, okay? I don't care. This for sure is bigger than 2 to the n xn by definition of this, how we construct this, times nn. But this is bigger or equal than 2 to the n times 2 to the minus n minus 1, that is equal to 1 half. So every time, anyhow, I go to the infinity at a certain point, I have the sum of these terms is equal to 1 half, okay, for any block. The sum of the first nth term on the nth block is bigger than 1 half, or smaller than minus 1 half, okay? And so 2 is checked, because this is a contradiction. So we have done.